So let's get into it. How did you get into real estate? Because I'm sure you didn't just wake up and you're like, I'm going to be a realtor. So
no, actually, I was in sales. And so I was working for Quiet Cool, awesome company right up the street, actually. But I was working for them and I was doing inside sales. I was doing in line to do outside sales and going around and going to talk to people. Hey, you want to be a rep? You want to be a dealer? You want to be an installer for Quiet Cool? And it was cool. I thought I was going to be there for forever. And as we started going through, I mean, I just kind of, I guess, started feeling like there's more to life than this, you know, and you start seeing like the salary cap is coming and the sales job position that I wanted wasn't opening fast enough, you know, and like, it's just like every corporate job, you know, they promise, especially when you're in it through the growth of the company, you know, it's like you get promised a lot and sometimes it just doesn't go that way as the company unfolds. No fault to anybody. It's just, that's the way the cards fall, you know? And so I'm sitting there one day and my wife was following James Shelby's wife and her Instagram, you know?
Yep.
And so Felicia. She started seeing James Shelby and she was like, look at this guy. Why can't you just be this guy? You know? And I was like,
we
it's always
all
nice when your wife says it to you.
Yeah.
And thanks a lot,
like,
honey.
Yeah. And I was like, I mean, yeah, he's pretty cool, man. Like he dresses nice. He's super snazzy. And she's like, I just don't see why you literally do the same exact thing, but you can't do what he's doing. And I'm like, yeah, you know what? You're right. Like, why not? Let's figure this out. And I called my dad literally in the car because my dad had his real estate license back in the day. Now he runs, he's ran car dealerships for as long as I can remember. But he goes back and forth sometimes. And he told me the school and stuff to go to, like some online course you go take and they'll give you your real estate license and they'll train you on how the business works and everything else, which is a total sham because you don't deal with any of the stuff on the test or that you go through school for. None of that even applies unless you're reading a contract. And so he sent me that and I went through that. I feel bad now that if word gets out there, I would go to work and I'd be on the phone or doing whatever. And I'd be sitting at my desk answering tech support calls and little calls and on the side doing my schoolwork and stuff right there. And so I got my license, I went over to Keller Williams, signed up with them. Cause I was just like, oh, they promised training and stuff like that. And I was like, that's what's up. I went to there, didn't get any training. A week later, James Shelby and Christian Stone were doing like a role play thing and it was open to everyone as they always post. So I came over here and James and Christian were like, dude, just come over. Like nobody cares about what brokerage you're with. Nobody cares about what you're with. It's about you. It's about the brand that you make, what it is that you build. It's about you. That's what they care about. And at least here, like Susan has the best setup for agents. If you're trying to, you take none of my money. I'm surprised this place is even in existence right now. Like, do you even charge me to be here at all?
No. I just love people.
But it's kind of nice, you know? And so seeing that, it was like, all right. So I jumped over real fast. That was an expensive mistake, by the way, to pay to sign up with Keller Williams and everything and then jump over. So if I could recommend to anybody, make sure you're committing to the right brokerage right off the bat, especially when you're trying to start in a business and you ain't got no money in the first place.
Yeah.
Make sure that you're not making any expensive mistakes.
Yeah.
That's so bad. But yeah, cause literally I did nothing with them. I signed with them, I changed, and it probably cost me almost $300-$400 easy.
Yeah.
Oh,
and so
then you got lucky cause it could be thousands.
Yeah. And yeah, it was a mess, man. And once you look at the splits and stuff like that, it just wasn't worth it. And to be on like their mentor program, like, I mean, I probably would have walked away with a 30% split by the time it was done, you know? And here it's like, yes, I'm still on a team, you know, let's get that at least straight. I'm not a solo agent. Okay. I'm too much of a procrastinator, too lazy to be a self-starter, right?
No, you're intelligent and you knew to fire yourself.
Okay. So me as a boss was a bad thing starting out. Okay. I feel like one day I'll be able to be like, I know this business enough to do it. Maybe, but I really like working with, I'm with Andrew Lewis Holmes and Andrew and Justin are just
awesome.
You have
a fantastic team.
Yeah. It's one of those things. Like I came and I was like, yeah, you know, I'll learn how to do it. I'll break off. I'll do my own thing. I'll, boom, be an awesome agent. And all of a sudden I work with them and I'm like, dude, these guys are awesome. Yeah. Like, I don't even want to, I'd rather try and negotiate a better split than go out on my own because they're just fun people to be around.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so it's, so that